Children's laughter fills the air. We celebrate the birthday of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Come on until after the next song. As I was saying,
we have an important question. Speaking on behalf of children everywhere, where is the singing Christmas tree?
Have you guys heard? We're not putting up the singing Christmas tree this year.
They're not putting up the singing Christmas tree?
My Christmas is ruined.
What do you mean Christmas is ruined?
The car's still here. And listen to the orchestra. They're fantastic. See all the beautiful lights and decorations?
And besides, the singing Christmas tree was just a small symbol of what's really important this time of year. If you all look real hard, I'm sure you'll find the real reason for Christmas.
Still, it's hard to get excited without that big tree.
Yeah, they've put up the singing Christmas tree ever since I was just a little kid. This is very disappointing. It just breaks my heart.
Don't worry, guys. We'll find a Christmas tree. Come on, guys. There must be a Christmas tree out there somewhere.
Don't worry. I'm smart. I'll find us a tree.
Daniel, what are you doing?
I'm Googling singing Christmas tree replacements.
We're not going to find a Christmas tree on Google. They're in the woods.
I just thought we might.
has directions.
While they're trying to find something better than a singing Christmas tree, maybe we can get Pale and Nathaniel into the Christmas spirit.
Merry Christmas!
tree than that.
But his tree didn't sing.
I know, let's forget about finding a Christmas tree and sing Christmas carols. Paola, what's your favorite Christmas carol?
Jingle Bells.
That's not a Christmas carol. What about you, Nathaniel?
What's wrong with Daniel?
He's really shy. He only talks to his older brother.
Well, Nathaniel, what's your favorite Christmas carol?
He said Grandma got run over by a reindeer.
No, you can't sing that in church.
Yes, that'd be highly inappropriate in a Baptist church.
He said he's considering becoming a Methodist.
Paola, do you know how to sing Jingle Bells?
Sure.
Then get us started.
Dashing through the snow
in one What do you mean, am I grown up?
Well, the singing Christmas tree was 30 years old, and ruined every single one that I ever saw. So you must be at least 30 years old.
I'm not 30 years old. I'm only in the 10th grade.
He said that makes you only 20 years old.
I'm not 20 years old either. I'm just, well, let's say that I'm still just a teenager. But thanks for the compliment. What are you guys doing here?
I guess you heard the news about the singing Christmas tree. Well, we're trying to find something bigger and better to replace the singing Christmas tree. Can you help us?
What's bigger and better than the singing Christmas tree? That's a really good question, but I think I might know. My friend's grandpa has been in the singing Christmas tree for as long as I can remember, and if anybody knows anything bigger than that big tree, Grandpa King will know. But first, let's sing along with the carol sing.
Would you please stand and join with us as we sing together, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel, and hark, the herald angels sing.
Join the tribe. I sure am. Grandpa King, at your service. And what might your name be?
My name's London, and these are my friends, Jan, Josiah, and Paola.
What's your name, young man?
He said his name is Nathaniel. He's really shy. He only talks to me.
Huh. Nathaniel and Josiah. Do you have an older brother? Well then, Nathaniel, Josiah, I bet his name is Moses.
No, our brother's name is Daniel. And our dad said that if we get another brother, he's gonna name him Song of Solomon.
I think it must be his favorite Old Testament book.
I happen to know that your father is Dr. Cribb, the great Bible professor and teacher. And I also know that every book in the Bible is his favorite book. I believe if you ask your dad, he would tell you you can find something much bigger and better than the singing Christmas tree in the pages of the Bible.
He said that if it's in the Bible, our dad won't know where to find it.
He's right. And I believe if you ask Dr. Cribb, he'll tell you the best and biggest thing in the Bible started out smaller than you, Paola.
What's smaller than Paola?
A baby. A very special baby. Listen.
Christ the baby.
Jesus was the promised Christ who was sent by God to save the world from their sins. Have you done bad things? Have you sinned? Well, God sent Jesus to pay for your sins. God sent Jesus for you. Jesus was born for you. Jesus lived a life without sin for you. Jesus died on the cross for you. Jesus rose from the grave for you. Here, let me show you in the Bible.
Sing a song of Bethlehem, the
pass that in those days a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the world should be taxed. Each went to their own city to be taxed.
So Joseph went up from Nazareth into the city of Judea and into Galilee and into the city of Bethlehem, which is the city of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, who was great with child.
So it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
Over their flocks by night.
And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid.
And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for I bring good tidings of great joy, which will be for all people. For unto you, in the city of David, a child is born, Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, you shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
Angels from God. Jesus.
I think we found it. I think we found something much bigger and more important than the singing Christmas tree. Yep.
Thank you.
For many, Christmas is not a season of joy. It's a season of discontent, dissatisfaction. Kids can't get enough presents. Parents can't get enough time off. Families can't get enough time together. In-laws sometimes have too much time together. But for many this Christmas, perhaps the reason that it's a season of discontent and dissatisfaction is we've looked for Christmas in all the wrong places. We settle for what's paltry and passing, when we could have the eternal and the extraordinary gift of Jesus Christ. Christ in the manger. Christ on the cross. Tonight you've heard the gospel presented in song. Tonight you've heard how Jesus still changes lives. And tonight, you've heard where to find Christmas. Tonight, if you have not found this Christ, this Christmas, this gospel, seek him. As Isaiah the prophet says, seek the Lord while he may be found, and call upon him while he is near. As the apostle Paul says, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved, and you will have found Christmas. May God bless you this Christmas season. And now for the finale of Finding Christmas.
Oh, on behalf of this great orchestra, this absolutely phenomenal choir behind me, these great young people, all the people up in the sound booth, all the people who work the lights, tonight we want all the praise and all the glory for what we have seen tonight to go to our blessed Lord Jesus. Would you give him praise tonight as we close our service? Let us bow our heads together in prayer. Father, tonight we want to thank you for the Spirit of the Lord who bears witness with our spirit. Lord, we want to thank you for the great, great choir. But Lord, we thank you for, most of all, the Lord about whom we sang. Lord, we love you tonight. Lord, we pray that you'll apply the music to all of our hearts. And as we leave these doors tonight, as we leave this place, may the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ shine through our lives during this Christmas season. In Jesus' name we pray. And all God's people said together, amen. Amen. Amen.